Japan, the land of the rising sun. But what's about the globalization in Japan? Globalization has had a significant impact in Japan's economy. It has affected every part of the economy, even in its culture. This year, I was in Japan and I wanted to investigate the situation. What are the positive and negative impacts of globalization in Japan? Positive impact of globalization in Japan includes the rise of economy. This due to advancement in technology. The advance in technology has allowed Japan to develop and manufacture modern equipment like cars, Toyota, Nissan, household products like Toshiba, and video arcade games, Sega, which are in high demand these days. This has enabled many technologies to take place in Japan, and Japanese factories are set up across the world because of its sustainable growth in making new products and technology, which then increases the growth in economy in Japan. Advancement in modern transportation systems and internet had also enabled the world to visit Japan because of the inspiring sceneries, which then led increases the income through tourism. It also has an impact on the culture, where the different aspects of culture in Japan has spread across the world, making them well known. For example, traditional culture of food like sushi and kimono has spread to other parts of the world and no longer just only exists in Japan, hence making the world becoming closer and smaller, because people can experience Japan's culture even if they are not in Japan. Anime and J-pop, which are part of Japan's modern culture, has reached to different parts of the world, where people from other countries draw and watch manga, anime, and do cosplay. However, it has also forced changes which are arguably negative on the Japanese life and economy. And I was thinking, what are the negative impacts of the globalization in Japan? Although the advancement in technology in Japan has benefited the economy. However, it also does some harm to the people living in Japan, as this technological advanced equipments like robots will make people lazy and depends on the equipments to survive. As a matter of economics, as worldwide demand increases, it requires more production and export. As the linked economies in the globalization market produce more, some states cannot maintain their standard of living simply because they have no resources to respond to the demand they face. China has overtaken Japan as an economic power because Japan lacked the human resources due to low birth rates. Due to globalization in Japan, many aspects in Japan's culture originality had been lost. For example, Western countries are not used to the taste of an Asian country. Hence, Japanese kitchen are being modified to suit their taste. and the traditional clothes worn by Japanese in the past are not seen wearing today by locals, mainly because they are being influenced by fashion by other parts of the world like America and France. Globalization is a means to an end. The end is to create and sustain a self-reinforcing cycle of profit growth and a value creation. Access to a rich asset and talent pool. And a more compelling value proposition for employees and investors. Getting there will be difficult. So I hope Japan continues to be the one of the mostly free economies.